Whoa, whoa, whoa. Cha-cha on the ballroom beat. Got two left feet. Get on the ballroom beat. They're dancing in the street. They're on the ballroom beat. We can tango, we can swing, we can do anything. Walking through the door and waltz on the floor. You wanna feel the heat? Get on the ballroom beat. Cha-cha on the ballroom beat. Foxtrot on the ballroom beat. Salsa on the ballroom beat. Cha-cha on the ballroom beat.
Good evening and welcome to On the Ballroom Beat. I'm your host, Lania Berger, and it's Dirty Dancing Night tonight. We are going to have a special Skype interview with Amanda Leigh Cobb. Amanda played Baby in the first North American tour of Dirty Dancing live on stage. So we're very excited to have Amanda Leigh Cobb from Dirty Dancing joining us later in the show. We're also going to show you how to take that Christmas bop and line dance that I taught you last week, how to take a section of it and turn it into some partner swing dancing, so that at your Christmas party, you will be absolutely set and ready to go with all of your dancing needs. But before we get into that, we're going to talk a little bit about some local studio news. In local studio news, we have the final week of the Tournament of Champions right now. Now, the Tournament of Champions has been going on for 5 weeks already, and here we are, week six. It's going to be time for the final competition. And on Friday night at 8 o'clock, we are going to have that competition. If we could pull that full screen, John, let's take a look at our finalists. A big congratulations to Jeffrey, to Juicy, Adele, Linda, Gisela, and Veronica. They are going to be the finalists in the 2014 Tournament of Champions at Arthur Murray Palm Harbor. Thank you, John. So they are going to be competing this Friday night for a $500 scholarship. And we are so excited to see these routines and more. We're also going to have a great showcase with some of the best routines of the Tournament of Champions. So make sure that you're at the studio for that. It's going to be a great night. Now we're inviting, of course, our students, but also alumni and people in the area who are dance lovers who would like to dance with us or even just come and watch the show. Please feel free to come to the Arthur Murray Dance Studio in Palm Harbor. We are located in the Fountains Plaza on Highway 19, just between Nebraska and Alderman. We're right behind Tiffany's restaurant. That's a good landmark to look for. And again, at the party, we'll have the competition. We'll have a lot of dancing, general dancing, and having fun, and then also some prizes and giveaways and some Christmas cheer. So please feel free to join us. Also, another exciting dance event happening this week. On Thursday night, tomorrow, we are going to be over at Leo's Italian Restaurant. Now, Leo's is very near the studio. It's just south of us on 19 between Nebraska and Tampa. And we love Leo's because, of course, they have great Italian food. It's a lovely restaurant. But better than that, they have live entertainment every night of the week. And they've got a dance floor set up, so it's a great place to go for dinner and dancing. And we are going to be going there on Thursday night around 9 o'clock so that we can enjoy the dancing and have a good time with Motown night. We also have the Christmas parade coming up. On Saturday, this Saturday, the parade steps off at 3 o'clock. It is a wonderful festive activity to take the kids to and come and experience. Like I said, it steps off at 3 o'clock and goes down Nebraska into the historic part of Palm Harbor, shoots across to Florida Avenue, and finishes at Harbor Hall and the White Chapel. So make sure that you gather everybody up and head to Palm Harbor for that. The Arthur Murray Palm Harbor dancers will be dancing in the parade, and Paul Dowers is going to be singing live in the parade. Now, I found a little clip of last year's parade, so I want to show you so you can see what it's all about. Here's a clip of last year's Christmas parade.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go, take a look at the 5 and 10, listening once again, with candy canes and silver blades aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store, prettiest sight to see is the hobby that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots are the wish of Bonnie and Ben. Dolls and we'll talk and we'll go for a walk are the hope of Janice and Jen. Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like
It is beginning to look a lot like Christmas, even right here at On the Ballroom Beat. Do you love Santa Claus over there? He's my lighting guy. So please join us for the Christmas parade this Saturday, 3 o'clock in downtown Palm Harbor. Now, of course, today is all about Dirty Dancing. And so, as you know, last week I got to go and see Dirty Dancing live on stage in Tampa at the Straz Center. What a great show. The movie came to life right before my eyes. The soundtrack is so exceptional and the dancing is top notch. Now, most of you, of course, are familiar with the Dirty Dancing, I've Had the Time of My Life, the Mambo Salsa that happens there at the end. But during the show, we also get to see some great tango, some cha-cha, some foxtrot. Just chock full of dancing. It's wonderful. It is still on tour. I believe it's in Jacksonville this week, and it's going to be on tour all the way through July. They finish in Fort Worth, Texas. So make sure you Google that and see if it's nearby you, because if it is, you've just got to go check it out. Of course I loved it. I'm a ballroom dancer. But what did the other patrons think of Dirty Dancing live on stage? Let's find out. Some of the patrons thought of the show. What's your favorite part of Dirty Dancing?
Oh my god, the last part when she actually did the jump. It was so amazing.
Did you have the time of your life tonight?
Of course
I did too. What was your favorite part?
Well, it was so sexy. It was so racy. I kind of felt flushed at parts. I mean, you really felt like you were in the movie, and you feel connected to the show that you've seen 100 times, you know every single word to.
And then of course all of the fabulous dancing, and especially the Time of My Life big finale with Baby and Jenny.
Did it make you want to get up and dance?
Well, yes. We're already talking about getting dance lessons.
Are you
Absolutely. We're dancing over here.
Thank you. We'll see you later.
Bye. It was a pleasure.
I think you can see everybody had the time of their life over at Dirty Dancing Live on stage. Now, we also had the opportunity to catch up with Jillian Muller after the show. Jillian played Baby she's playing Baby on the tour that's going around right now, and we asked her a little bit about what it was like to train for the dancing in this iconic role. Let's see what she had to say. Hi, and welcome to On the Ballroom Beat. I am here with Jillian Muller, and she just got finished playing Baby in tonight's Dirty Dancing live on stage. Hi, Jillian. It's great to have you.
Thank you.
So tell me, what was it like training for this role? And how long did it take you to get comfortable with the dancing?
Honestly, the rehearsal process, because I'm not, you know, the ensemble of the show kind of heavily carries that. I'm more, especially towards the beginning of the show, kind of have to be a bad dancer, so it allows me to kind of not pick up on it right away. So I guess that was helpful in learning.
And I wanted to ask you, you're a fabulous dancer. Is it hard to play a bad dancer?
You know what, in the beginning, because you just kind of feel like such a phony, you're like, no, people pay good money to see a show. I don't want to be bad. But it's fun, and it's easy, because I focus more on maybe being quirky, and that kind of helps it kind of come out.
Well, you were absolutely fabulous tonight.
Way. Thank you.
Thank you so much for taking time with us today, and good luck on the rest of the tour.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
I am going to get a light for my next field work out there. Sorry, it's so dark, but wasn't that great to see what Jillian had to say and to hear a little bit about the training? We're going to learn more about training for that show, because we'll be with Amanda Leigh Cobb after the commercial break. But first, I have David Schmidt here with me. David is the dance director at Arthur Murray Dance Studio in Palm Harbor. Welcome, David.
Happy to be here, Lania.
Now, being dance director, I like to say that kind of means that he's the Yoda of dance. Would you agree with that?
Yes, it's very true.
So David knows all of the dance steps inside and out. He's a fantastic, fantastic dancer, great teacher. He's also a top teacher from Jamlando 2014, and he's been a champion for dancing with the Palm Harbor Stars, dancing with the local stars, professional competitor, all sorts of good stuff. But enough about that, we got to dance, right?
Yep.
Okay, so what we're going to do today is show you how to turn the Christmas bop and line dance that I showed you last week into a nice partner. So David and I are going to review first what we did last time. You're going to get your right foot ready. We're going to be mirroring you, so we're going to get our left. So the first thing that we did was the triple swing, and then the triple swing section. And we did a side step, and then we closed our feet, and then we did one more side step. And John, if we can open up just a little bit to get the feet, I don't know if that's possible. And we're going to take the other foot and rock back with it, and then come forward. Then we're going to do the same thing to the other side. Side, together, side. Take this back foot, rock back with it, and then come forward. So again, we have side, together, side, rock, step, side, together, side, and rock, step. Now to turn this into a swing basic, all we're going to do is eliminate one of the rock steps. So we're going to do the exact same thing, head to your right. You're going to go side, together, side. Instead of rocking, we're going to move back that way. Side, together, side, and then we're going to do one rock, step. So side, together, side, rock, step. It's one and two, three and four, five, six. Now when we put this together with a partner, the leader is going to start on his
left foot.
L for leader, L for left. And the lady is going to start on her right foot. Why is that?
Because she's always right.
Absolutely. Isn't he great? So the lady's always right. She's going to start on her right foot. So what we're going to do is we're going to hold hands here. And I'm going to start with my right foot, and David's going to start with his left foot. We're going to take a triple to the side, another triple to the side, and then rock, step. So we dance one and two, three and four, rock, step. As we're dancing this, we can allow it to rotate. Rock, step, one and two, three and four, rock, step. I can keep this two-hand hold, or I can close it up. Or I should say, and he can close it up because he's the one making the decisions. And that's how we dance our triple swing basic. We're going to do a little bit of that to music. You ready for some Christmas bopping?
Absolutely.
Okay, John, we're ready for Christmas bopping.
Got you bopping. Got you bopping.
Absolutely.
So we will look forward to seeing all of you at the Christmas party, dancing your Christmas bop and line dance and swing dancing. Now, let's talk about dirty dancing. David, have you ever done the dirty dancing routine?
Several times.
Can you tell us about that?
Well, it's incredibly exciting for everyone who's learned it. And I've had a different variety of talent levels learn it. I've had one person who was a theater major and she learned it because she grew up with it and it was her favorite mm-hmm. thing ever. And I had a wedding couple one time learn the entire thing.
For appropriate
too. No, yes. And I didn't dumb anything down for them. And he had never danced before. She had never danced before. And their height level was pretty much like ours, basically. And they did it wonderfully. I was so proud of both of them.
Do you think that that's the most requested routine that we get in the studio?
It's one of the many requests we get from the studio for wedding dances,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, I mean, for wedding dances, but beyond that, because it's just so iconic to anybody who loves dance. I know I've danced it in Showcase before. You did it in a Dancing with the Stars competition with Capria. Mm-hmm. We've had this routine so many times in the studio, and we love it. It's so much fun. So before we get to Amanda Leigh Cobb, let's take a look at Kristen Stillwell, one of our students, in the role of baby with Johnny, with our Johnny being our teacher, Misha. They did this routine for the Tournament of Champions this year, and they're going to take us to the commercial.
Wiggle, wiggle, Kristen, wiggle, wiggle.
Do I live like this
before? Woo!
Yes, I swear.
Ow!
Oh! And I hope
you
won't be close.
Woo!
And I only love you.
Everyone's story is different, so why be limited to just one or two options? With Norcom's Norflex Home Loan, you're given the flexibility to tell your story. Pick your terms from 8 to 30 years, all while maintaining a low, fixed mortgage rate. You can pay off your loan more quickly or choose a term based on your budget and timeline. Whatever you do with the Norflex Home Loan, make it part of your financial plan. Norflex. Short term, long term, your terms. Apply online at norcommortgage.com.
Beltran Dental Surgery is dedicated to providing the highest quality dental surgery.
Teeth in a Day allows a patient to walk in with their old teeth, sleep under IV sedation, and walk out with a brand new smile. Unlike dentures, Teeth in a Day allows you to eat what you want and still feel like you have your own teeth.
From wisdom teeth removal to implants or creating a whole new smile, call now or visit our website to learn more about our procedures. Get a brand new smile today.
This is one bee that loves going to the dentist because it's made for you and me.
My name is Dr. Bezerra from New Tampa Pediatric Dental, providing a comfortable atmosphere and early dental care. Gives kids a great start for healthy teeth and gums for life.
My middle son did not like to come to the dentist, but now he loves to come to the beehive.
You don't have to be afraid to go to the dentist.
Believe me, Dr. B and his worker bees are the best. Call New Tampa Pediatric Dental today.
Revolutionary in his field, Dr. Benatti created, perfected, and patented the Benatti spine procedures. Using his genius, Benatti invented precise tools necessary to minimize surgery, scarring, anesthesia, and recovery. So successful are the Benatti spine procedures, they consistently reflect over 94% patient satisfaction. 45,000 successful procedures have been performed exclusively at our location. Nearly half our patients suffer from failed back and neck surgeries at other facilities. Benatti succeeds where others fail.
The last several years have been confusing and trying for homeowners. Advisors Mortgage and Financial Group was there before the housing crisis, during, and we are still here now advising people of their options and helping them choose the best financial solutions for their family. You do have options, and today's market promises lots of opportunities. We have found that there are a lot of questions out there and misinformation, and we want you to know we have answers. Advisors Mortgage and Financial Group, providing solutions today for a better tomorrow.
Welcome back to On the Ballroom Beat. We are very excited to have set up a Skype interview with Amanda Leigh. Now, Amanda's up in New York, and so we get to talk to her through the airwaves, if you will, on a Skype interview. She's going to be with us in just one moment. Amanda was the first baby on the North American tour of Dirty Dancing Live on stage. Now, of course, and so we at On the Ballroom Beat were very curious to hear what it was like to train for such a role. Here's what she had to say. Hi, I'm Lania with On the Ballroom Beat, and with me today we have the lovely Amanda Leigh Cobb. Welcome to the show, Amanda.
Thank you so much for having me. It's my pleasure to be here.
Now, Amanda Leigh Cobb was the original baby on the North American tour of Dirty Dancing Live on stage. Amanda, what was it like to bring that iconic role to life?
Well, I'm not going to say it was easy. It was certainly a challenge, but I will say it was the most fun I've ever had.
That's incredible. Now, when you were researching the role to prepare for it, did you watch Dirty Dancing a lot? Did you watch it a little?
You know, I actually did not watch a lot. It's a funny story. I went in to audition for the role, never thinking in a million years that I would actually get it. And when they offered me the part, I thought I should probably rewatch this movie that I remembered but hadn't seen in a really long time. So my boyfriend at the time and I, he had a VHS player. I still had it on VHS. I dug it out. We popped it in. And we had a ball rewatching it. I would have to pause every once in a while and kind of shake my head and freak out a little bit that I was about to embark on this. And then, you know, we'd press play again and keep watching it some more. After that, though, I put it away and I didn't rewatch the movie at all during the entire rehearsal process or even during the year that we were performing, because I wanted to kind of bring myself to the role and keep it fresh, and I didn't want to feel like I was trying to imitate Jennifer Grey. So I put it away and just kind of hoped for the best with my interpretation, I guess.
That's incredible. I've got to tell you, in the photographs and whatnot from Dirty Dancing Live on Stage, you look just like Jennifer Grey. What's the process like to become baby?
Well, it was a long process, and it becomes kind of ritualistic after a while. So you've got, you know, your normal sort of half hour before the show would start. We would always start about an hour before with a vocal warm-up, a physical warm-up, and then I would be tucked into my dressing room, and I had an amazing hair and makeup team where I would get rigged up. My wig was fantastic. You've seen the pictures. They did such an amazing job with that. My baby wigs. But because I was on stage pretty much the entire show, I needed two microphones just in case something happened to one of them during the show, because of course I never left the stage to get a backup mic. So one of those tiny little microphones had to live inside my wig at the base of my scalp. So I had one little microphone that was fastened around my waist under my costume that the sound guys helped me get rigged into before every show, and another microphone that sort of went up my back and was taped onto my head because it was the only other place we could figure out to put it because of all the costume changes and the dancing. So, you know, it took a while to get geared up, but we were well practiced, and it became old hat after, you know, the 20th show or something. We had it down.
That's incredible. And, you know, I did have the privilege of seeing Dirty Dancing Live on Stage in Tampa Bay last week. And it was fantastic. And you're right, baby never leaves the stage, essentially. I mean, a couple quick costume changes, that had to be incredible for you.
That's right. I mean, I was in really good shape when I was doing the show, that's for sure, because it requires a lot of stamina, not just the dancing, of course, but those costume changes, sort of exiting stage right, running around the back of the set, changing costumes, entering stage left. It felt like a sprint for about 2 hours. So I was in really good shape, but yeah, it's not for the faint of heart, that's for sure.
Now, you mentioned the dancing. Of course, baby does the mambo. I also saw some cha-cha, some foxtrot. Did you know ballroom dancing before you were cast in the role, or did you learn it afterward?
I learned it afterward, actually. The only dancing that I had ever done was with my family growing up. I was really into swing dancing. That sort of became the craze. I grew up in Texas in my hometown. So I would swing dance quite a bit, and that's really all I knew. So for the auditions, they were beautiful dancers around working with me, helping me. David was the main choreographer at that time for our tour. And I just remember having a ball, literally, in the audition process with what little swing dancing I knew, just trying to keep up, sort of laughing at myself. It was a good time. And then, of course, I had sort of ballroom boot camp when we got to Chicago and had to try to learn everything and keep up. So I kind of looked at it like free dancing lessons for a year, which was pretty fantastic.
It's great that you were doing some swing dancing before, because you learn a lot of the basic principles of lead and follow in swing and a lot of different turns and things like that. Do you feel like that helped you and kind of incorporated itself into your mambo and cha-cha?
Oh, absolutely. It's just what you said, you know, the leading and the following, working closely with a partner and having fun. So all of that helped, and all of that came into play so that I was able to sort of pick up the other dances much, much easier if I had had no training or no dancing in my background whatsoever. So it helped for sure.
Now, one of my favorite dance scenes, of course, I love the part on the log. We all remember that. That's just an iconic scene that is out of this world. But yeah. I, as a dance instructor, loved when Johnny was teaching you to wait for the two in the mambo. Because for all of our viewers out there who take ballroom dance lessons, if you've studied mambo, you know that that is the hardest part of mambo, is waiting for that two. Did you find that challenging as well?
Yes, I did. And it was funny because I would try to practice the dances, you know, off stage But what was great about it, of course, was that baby does mess up time and time again. So once that's choreographed into the dancing, it was, of course, much easier for me to be able to choreograph those mess ups for sure.
Well, the music of Dirty Dancing sure does make you want to get up and move. And something that I learned while I was seeing the show is that Eleanor Bergstein actually added back in some songs that she initially wanted for the movie. They disapproved it back when she was asking in 87. And so she took this opportunity, putting it live on stage, to bring them back into the show. Are there any other changes that have happened from the movie into the show?
Well, I must say that I haven't seen the current U.S. tour. So whether or not they've edited this script currently, I can't say. But what I can tell you is that in the version that I did, the original American tour a few years ago, there were scenes that Eleanor had originally written into the script that got cut for the movie. And some of those scenes found their way back into the musical. So one that I can think of off the top of my head is a sort of, I call it the Kumbaya scene, where they're talking about Martin Luther King, and there's more sort of politics, the civil rights movement. There are a couple of scenes that were added in, at least at that time, that were not in the movie, but did make it to the musical.
Did you get a chance to meet Eleanor at all while you were rehearsing?
Oh, yes. She was around the entire time, from beginning to end. You know, our relationship started the first day that I went to audition. She was in the room for, I would say, every rehearsal. She was with us, I believe, through previews. She went and worked on some other productions. I believe there was one in Utrecht that was started while we were currently performing in Chicago. I believe she went to Germany as well. But she would take frequent flights back to us. So she was available and she was around and extremely close to the process from the very beginning.
That's incredible. Especially, I've got to tell you, for those of us who grew up with the movie and fell in love with those dance scenes, what a treat to get to work hand in hand with Eleanor on her baby. I mean, that turned into a classic. It's incredible. I have one other question for you. I know that you're in New York right now, and again, thank you for Skyping in with us. And I know that you've done some other Broadway shows. We were talking about earlier the importance of being earnest and how you're teaching at NYU now. Can you tell us a little bit about some of the projects that you're working on and where our viewers might be able to come up to New York and see you?
Sure. Well, you did mention The Importance of Being Earnest, which was an amazing production that Brian Bedford starred in. He brought down the original Canadian cast, and they performed here on Broadway at the Roundabout. And I was actually understudying both Gwendolyn and Cecily, if you're familiar with the Oscar Wilde play, and had the opportunity to go on a couple of times, actually, as Gwendolyn. So that was great, because while the musical was amazing, my roots are really in classical text and sort of period dramas. That's where I got my start. So it was lovely to be able to return to that. And I did a couple of more shows regionally, Clybourne Park and some others. But lately, as you mentioned, I've started teaching at NYU. I teach scene study there, and I love it. My students are very talented. I teach sophomores, so second year of college there. And I do that part-time, and I've actually started to shift my focus away from the stage. Oh, I can hear the train. Away from the stage and into audiobook work. So I've recorded a lot of books in the past year. You can check them all out under my name on Audible, and I just recently finished my own sound booth. So my goal is to kind of expand that, where I have a little bit more control, and I can narrate and also produce.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, so all that's on my website. You know, you can see old baby Dirty Dancing pictures. You can see what I'm up to now, which is basically just my name. It's www.amandaleighcobb.com. So if you're curious, you can check stuff out there.
And you said you're doing some audio recordings. What's the most recent one that you've done?
Let's see. I just finished a book called High Stakes. And there are two books that are recently out. One is Wild Iris Ridge, and that's a great family romance. And there's a much anticipated book coming out by Jane Ann Krentz. She has quite a following. And that book is called Trust No One. And that book should be coming out any moment now. Hopefully this month, I think.
Excellent. Now, with your ballroom training that you had in dancing or in Dirty Dancing, do you feel like that has improved auditions or any type of aspect of your life?
Well, I definitely miss the shape that I was in when I was dancing full time. I have gotten a little bit back into swing dancing because, as you remember, that was sort of my first love. But I think ballroom dancing in general is great for everyone because body awareness is such an amazing thing, and it's such a magnetic thing from dancers to sort of corporate America to just be able to sort of express yourself and feel comfortable in your own body is really important. So, you know, I would recommend anyone take a ballroom dance class. I think everyone can benefit from it. Just feeling sort of more secure in your body and being able to take up more space in a room is a really, really incredible thing.
You said that beautifully. Are you ready for your pop quiz, Amanda?
Oh my gosh. Okay. Yes.
Okay. Here we go. Sweet or salty?
Salty.
Ah. High heels or flats?
Flats.
Okay. And do you drink coffee or tea?
Coffee.
Favorite pizza topping?
Mushrooms.
Dirty Dancing quiz time. Where did Johnny Castle learn how to ballroom dance?
Johnny Castle learned how to ballroom dance. Oh, let me think. Oh, gosh.
I'm going to help you out with this one. It was at Arthur Murray.
Oh, Arthur Murray.
It was. And let me tell you, this is a fun fact. Eleanor, the writer of Dirty Dancing, worked at Arthur Murray during college.
Oh, I did not know
that.
Yeah,
she did. She was an Arthur Murray instructor, which is, of course, what inspired, you know, a lot of the story is her time at Arthur Murray's. And then I've also heard that Patrick Swayze's mother was an Arthur Murray instructor. And that Patrick, and now in the play they didn't, or excuse me, in the musical they didn't say it, but in the movie he says, I learned at Arthur Murray. And he said that sort of as a tribute to his mom, which I thought was really cool.
Yeah,
anyway. So Arthur Murray's it is. Listen, Amanda, this has been fantastic chatting with you. We wish you all the luck in the world with all of your future endeavors, and we thank you so much for taking time with us here on the Ballroom Beat.
Thank you. Well, it was my pleasure to be here. Best of luck to everyone out there, and thanks for the chat. I appreciate it.
Thanks. Bye now.
Bye-bye.
We had such a lovely time chatting with her. Such a great interview and a pleasure to have you on the Ballroom Beat. Now, make sure that you tune in next week. It is our Christmas episode, and so we're going to be talking about all things Christmas. We'll look at the Christmas Boppin' music video, the Christmas parade, and some other fun Christmas surprises for you along the way. And speaking of Christmas, don't forget that it is time for some Christmas shopping, and there's nothing better than an Arthur Murray gift certificate for your gift-giving needs. Arthur Murray's dance lessons, we do have gift certificates, And they're the gift that lasts a lifetime. And they don't take up any space in your house. That's what I keep suffering with myself with my Christmas shopping. I don't want to, you know, clutter the house too much. So anyway, we'll see you next week for some Christmas fun. Until then, I'm Lania Berger, and I'll see you on the Ballroom Beat.
Cha-cha on the Ballroom Beat. Whoa, 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 cha-cha on the ballroom beat. Got two left feet, get on the ballroom beat. They're dancing in the street, they're on the ballroom beat. We can tangle, we can swing, we can do anything. Walking through the door and waltz on the floor. You wanna feel the heat? Get on the ballroom beat. Cha-cha on the ballroom beat. Foxtrot on the ballroom beat. Salsa on the ballroom beat. Cha-cha on the ballroom beat.